Hi guys, and welcome to a new guitar tutorial. In this video I'm going to show you how to play the song Teeth. And to play this song we have to tune the guitar in drop D, and that's playing all the strings in standard tuning, but the sixth string we have to tune that in D. So we get the first string an E, the second a B, the third a G, the fourth a D, the fifth an A, and the sixth a D. So when we have that tuning, we are going to start with the intro of the song, and we're going to put the index finger on the first fret, sixth string, and we play that tone four times, but between every tone we have a rest. So we're going to stop holding down the finger like this. You get it? After that, we're going to play on the fifth string the second fret with the middle finger, the first fret with the index finger, and then on the sixth string, fourth fret with the pinky finger, and first fret with the index finger. And we're going to play that melody two times. It and then we get the first two measures of the song. I play one more time. Okay, and after that we're going to repeat this melody, but we're going to end, instead of playing two times that melody, the last tone, instead of playing the first fret on the sixth string, we're going to play the fourth fret on the fifth string. So that second time sounds like this. That's the only difference. So putting together the fourth measures, we get the intro. Okay, I play one more time. And before we continue with the video, if this is your first time in this channel, please subscribe and click on the bell so you don't miss anything. Okay, so that's how we play the intro. Then when we start with the verse, we're going to start playing the intro again. The first part of the verse is the same riff as we played on the intro. So we play again. Okay, and then we arrive to the measure 9. And then we're going to play the second measure on the 5th fret with the middle finger. We play that 4 times, as well with rest between every tone. After that, we're going to play again that melody that we played before. Second first, fourth first. Two times as well. So playing the measure 9 and 10, we get this. Get it? I play one more time. Okay, then we come back to the second fret on the fifth string. Play it 4 times, and now we're going to change a little bit that melody. We start on the same way, 2nd, 1st on the 5th string, 4th on the 5th string, but after that we come back to the 2nd fret on the 5th string. You get it? And then we play on the 5th string the frets 4, 1st, 4th, and then 1st on the 6th string. So that's the melody that we use when we end the verse. Okay, so there we have the second part of the verse. I'm going to play from the measure 9. Thank you. it. So now I'm going to play the whole verse from the measure 5. And we have to play it 2 times, so when we end there, we just have to start again. Okay, and that's how you play the verse of the song. So now let's talk about the pre-chorus. In the original song, we don't have any guitar on the pre-chorus, but we can play like this. If we put the index finger holding down the first fret on the 6th, 5th and 4th strings at the same time, and on the right hand, we play it 8 times, like this. And I think that it sounds better if we mute the strings there. If we use palm muting, we put this side of the hand right after the bridge to mute the strings a little bit. Okay, then we move that index finger to the 4th fret and we play the same thing. So 8 times. Okay, then we're going to play a power chord on the 2nd fret 5th string, and that's putting the index finger on the 2nd fret 5th string, the ring finger on the 4th fret 4th string, and pinky finger on the 4th fret 3rd string. So now on the right hand we have to play the strings 5, 4 and 3. And now we play it 4 times. Then we move that position 2 frets up, and we play it 4 times again, and we come back to the 1st fret. So now we play again the 6th, 5th and 4th. 8 times again. Okay, so the beginning of the pre-chorus sounds like this. You get it? I play one more time. And once we have played that, we have to repeat again, but we're going to skip the last chord. So we start with the 1st fret, 4th, and we stay there, instead of coming back to the 1st fret. And what we do to start the chorus is that we have a rest, like this, 1, 2, 3, and as soon as we say 3, we're going to play the 2nd fret on the 5th string, 4th fret on the 5th string, 1st fret on the 4th string. So like this. 1, 2, 3. Play one more time. 1, 2, 3. So that's how you play the pre-chorus. I'm going to play the whole pre-chorus. And then we start with the chorus, and on the chorus we are just going to play the same thing that we played on the verse, exactly the same thing, and we play it 2 times as well. So you know how to play the chorus already, and after the chorus we're going to play the verse again, but we're going to start a little bit different. We're going to start with a rest, so when we end the chorus we do 1, 2, 3, 4. That's how we start the 2nd verse, when the singer sings along. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then what we do is that we play almost that melody, but we're going to change a little bit when we play the 2nd time. When we come to that 4th fret on the 6th string, we're going to stay there. So we don't play the 1st fret on the 6th string. Okay, and after that we just have to continue with the riff as we played on the 1st verse. And that's how you play teeth. I hope that you enjoyed this lesson, and I see you in the next one.